Hey y'all. Okay, so today we have my lovely client, Sarah. Okay, and so as y'all can see, she has locks. Okay, let me turn you this way. And we put, when did we put these babies?
Ooh, April 28th.
April? Look at you, remember your lock anniversary, period. So it hasn't even been a year yet, and you guys can see how her hair is already locking up beautifully. And also, if you can see from her roots, let me see if I can bring that a little closer, that her hair is pretty straight. So yes, we were able to get her straight hair locked. Mm-hmm. Her hair's pretty like wavy, you could say. We were able to get it to this within under a year using the instant lock method. So this is why I stress to y'all when it comes to starting your lock journey to avoid the budding phase and all that craziness, avoid the tangling and constantly having to come back to the salon or not being able to hydrate your hair because you have coils or twisting. That takes you away from all that. It's the best method ever, to me at least, okay? I will be hosting a class for instant locks. Link will be in the description below for those who are interested. I am based out in Miami, so if you're gonna be in town in February 11th, then you are good to go to be a part of class. I do have two different types of tickets. One would be hands-on, and the other is for look and learn. Look and learn is usually for those who's much more experienced and who just wants to get more additional feedback on how to master their craft or their technique. And the hands-on is mainly for those who don't really get it and need some hands-on, personal, close, one-on-one guidance from me. Now, we're gonna go ahead and give her a shampoo, and we're going to also not condition, but we're gonna leave a leave-in. We're gonna use a leave-in spray. A leave-in conditioner spray, a light leave-in conditioner spray to avoid creating buildup. And I did assess her scalp. She has a little bit of flaking, but her scalp does not have any redness and plaque or anything like that. So we're good on that level. Her scalp is likely just flaking due to buildup because it has been a while. So we're gonna assess all that in a little bit. I got my steamer out. We're gonna steam her hair and scalp. We're gonna use a clarifying, and then we're gonna use my scalp wellness shampoo, and then I'm probably gonna use a honey detangling shampoo to help with the roots and to help soften the locks, and then get you out, and then use the leave-in spray by Miss Ani. Okay, bet. Stay tuned. It was gonna take me away from a community that I'm currently serving, right? Yeah. Like, not even just like clientele. Like, that was one issue at first, but it became more of like, there's a demographic that I want to continue to serve. Like, I want to be that go-to for this demographic. Yeah. And I'm not hating on all the others, you know what I'm saying? I just know that my certain demographic is very short-staffed on, you know, having professionals and experts, you know, leading in that industry to help others.
Yeah.
So, I felt like low-key it was gonna detour me from my path. So the fact that that didn't really go through, and I feel like that's something that might creep back around like a couple years or something, right? Yeah. And I'm glad that happened so that way I can actually take the focus to establish my platforms online, which would be my academy mainly. You know, if they hired me, I would have been focused on building their academy.
Exactly.
And when I was speaking to them, I was already letting them know, like, I'm coming to you with, like, you know, facts. Remember how we discussed intellectual property, finding a way to, like, have, you know, my royalties set into place if I'm creating your curriculum.
Exactly.
So, I guess they realized I was not... They just want somebody to do stuff for them and not take ownership of any of the things that they create for that company.
Yeah.
And I am not her because I know my value and I know how far I can go with what I create.
And you gotta believe they would take all that and build on it and give it to them. You know, like, they will monetize it.
Absolutely.
For their interests.
Absolutely.
Like, way more than it would benefit you at the end of the day.
Yep. So that's where I'm like, okay, let me just establish myself more throughout these big, giant social platforms. Actually go in, because I wasn't going in before it was more of like just work. Now it's like, what, 2024, I'm fucking it all the way up. Okay.
It
was great because YouTube has been reacting pretty well to the content I've been posting lately.
Oh,
nice. And literally, I've been posting like a video every day at least. Like, it's ridiculous.
Everybody says it's the numbers game, like that it is really like volume, you know, just that they
Absolutely. You have to force it. Because before I kept making excuses, and then I realized, okay, now at this point, y'all just gonna have to catch this work of like, well, let me bring this down a little bit. I'm like, y'all just gonna have to catch this work as far as if my phone calls, y'all just gonna have to see that.
Right.
If my son comes in with a snotty nose, y'all just gonna have to see that
right.
At this point, because I can't keep making excuses, okay? I can't be editing these videos. I'm just gonna see and hear all my long-winded conversations. You're gonna have a little laugh, probably get a little angry, don't care. If you want this information, you're gonna come get this information.
Yeah.
I'm not wasting time on this pretty stuff, because that's what caused me to not have analysis paralysis in the first place. So now it's just like, man, fuck it, just record it and send it. We're done with all that.
I love that you said it. The analysis paralysis is real.
What?
I'm like the queen of that.
Like, it first started out with what they call it, when you don't think you're worth giving the information that you know you know.
Mm-hmm.
But there's,
Right? Like, kind of like imposter syndrome.
Yes. I felt like I was struggling with that for like a year straight.
Mm-hmm.
And then it turned into that, like, okay, well, it's not perfect enough. And it's like, bro, who cares? And luckily now, with the help of AI, it's like, Deborah, you really have no excuse. You gotta force this stuff into your time.
All those like anxieties show that you can't. Like, you set a high bar for yourself, and that's good. I mean, you having that trait is what's gonna make you a successful entrepreneur. Period. Like, once you just have to get over that fear of like making it, like you said, like paralyze you. But
you're absolutely right about that.
Those standards are important.
I'm trying to work in integrity here as much as I possibly can, but I am still growing. I am still developing. You know what I'm saying? I don't know everything. And I don't want people to think that I do, but I do know that there's a lot that I know that I can help others. So it's like, okay, you know what? Fuck it. Let me just share it. And if it evolves, if it changes, I'm transparent. I'm at that phase in my life where I can hold myself accountable enough to be vulnerable and transparent to where I have made mistakes or said things that maybe wasn't true, where I can correct myself. You know what I'm saying? Like, probably past DJ, 3-4 years ago, DJ, my ego would have been so big to where it's like, not doing it, don't care, right? But now it's like, okay, I'm open to hearing other people's perspectives. I'm open to hearing, okay, what's your thought process on that if you don't agree with me? Like, it's a different, I guess, maturity, girl. That age be hitting, girl. Ugh. That age be aging. Just turned 29. Ugh.
Oh, you're almost 30.
Yuck. What is happening? Yuck. So, yeah, with that being said.
But there's something, I mean, now that I'm past the 4-0 mark, but I do think, like, the 30 thing, like, there's also something very liberating about this transition, like, that. And people say 29 is, like, the Saturn return.
Bro, I heard.
Like, oh, yeah. I think this is important. This is my son's friend. FaceTime.
Yo, it be like that. I just recently heard about Saturn's return thing too, and how
completion.
Yeah, I'm big into astrology, so I'm just like, well, okay. So I know this means things. You know, it's not as there's not as much pressure as there was before, and like I start to figure things out, and like I fall into my calling, and things like that. Things start to fall into place, and I grow into the person I'm supposed to become around this time.
Yep.
So. I think that's why it's like ever since November of last year during Sag season. I am a Sag moon and Sag rising, so wouldn't be shocked. But there's like a light, a fire that's just been under my ass. Okay, like it's just like you need to get this stuff out. Retirement coming around the corner. Your son's going to middle school. Like there's things you need to do, sis. People need you. There's what. So I guess you know, depending on their thing or whatever. I hear you loud and clear. So how was Christmas for you?
It was good, you know, like we're not super religious or anything like that. And we do Christmas for the kids, but it's not like a big, we try to make it too much of a thing.
Tell me that I'm never gonna make it. They want me to do something that can make sense. They hate when I keep dreaming I'll be famous.
Right, gifts and stuff. Of course. Yeah, you gotta earn this stuff at least.
Come on. Just like understanding why
I love that. Absolutely. I mean, you're gonna get something, but it's deeper than that. It's much deeper than that. I love that.
No, we're not all the way there, but the balance.
That's so beautiful. I mean, as much as I think holidays are a scam, I do totally believe in, like you said, turning it around and getting some form of, like, lesson, some fruit from that, like getting some of the seed, like getting, being able to spend time with family,
exactly,
having deeper conversations with family, like you said, getting to know each other well enough to where you can be thoughtful enough to give them something, knowing what they want, knowing what they need, you know, having that emotional sentiment and ties with others, you know, prioritizing what's important, which is people, time with people,
and then it can feel family. Good to give something that's like, you know,
nice. And yes, the act of giving
us,
in itself.
Like, like, it shouldn't be about that. Like, mm-hmm. Yes, I'm gonna give you some gifts, and I should enjoy getting you gifts as much as anything. You know, like, this whole thing is about family time and about valuing each other, appreciating each other. Mm-hmm. It shouldn't be this, like, super stressful
time.
But
yeah.
Like, we have to adjust how we're doing it if it becomes that. You know?
I love that. I agree. Get some you time.
A little bit.
Yeah. Anything helps.
I
hear you, girl.
I'm like, let 2 weeks. See, when we live in girl. New York, they only get a week off.
What?
So they basically just get off between Christmas and New Year's. And like, I'm not used to it. This is the first time I've done this, like, 2 weeks. Where I was like, and it really felt like longer than 2 weeks because they were out, like,
they probably had early releases, so.
They did. Like, that Thursday before.
Yeah, they do. Like, oh, maybe like, on Friday off too. Like, what?
Yeah. Like,
Monday, right. Okay, forget that. My son was up. It was me. My son went to sleep at like 1 in the morning, which he should have.
And still woke up.
Y'all would be like, oh my God, you gotta go to school. Okay. Why don't they have school buses?
I know. That's what I'm saying. So I'm applying where my son goes to school now. They have magnet programs starting in third grade.
Ooh.
And it's an arts magnet, so they have drama, music, dance, and visual arts.
Yes.
And so he's interested in the drama program. I'm doing the application now. Yay. I'm just hoping he gets it, because if he does, it turns out that Miami-Dade will bus him because he lives outside of, like,
oh no,
there's some kind of zone, you know, like, if you're too close to the school, they won't bus you,
but if you look too far, they will, absolutely.
Yeah, so because we're not, like, we're probably, like, it's not even a 15-minute drive, but it's, like, or it's about 15, I would say, most days, but I'm just, like, oh my god, get a bus.
I hope, yeah.
I'm just so happy.
Yeah, I hope that works out for real. That'd be dope for him to be in drama.
Look at him. I'm hoping. He's so ready. He was just trying to decide between drama and music because he really is into music. But I was trying to explain to him, like, I just don't think the music program is what
he thinks it's gonna be. Yeah, it's so basic. It's so bland. It's like, so, it's not fun.
You don't get to, like, pick your instrument or do what you know. Yeah. And I was like, I'm not discouraging it. If you want to do it, like, obviously I'm gonna support that.
Yeah.
Because also, like, I want him to do drama because he's so kind of, like, hyperactive or something.
Yeah, I can still.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and, like, I need that. I think him having, like, the way the program is, it's like an hour at the beginning of the day, every day.
Okay.
So, like, that's perfect for you. Like, you can actually move your body. You know what I mean? Like, say, so he's that kind of person. And, like, having to go to school.
He be waking up with energy like that?
He
does. What? God damn. I can't. And you got two? I'm good.
Still all day long. I'm like, this is something where you can, like, get some energy out first thing in the morning.
Yeah,
you know?
So you can then calm down throughout the rest of the day.
Yeah, and the fact that I'm like, you like to run around, like, that's not what music is about. Like,
it's just so true.
They make you, like, he has an ear, so I don't, like, so
at,
like,
the same time, yeah.
I was like, it's all part of it. They have a voice coach that comes in once a week.
Ooh.
And so I was just like, to me, it's the best of both worlds.
Yeah, you know? I love that.
And I was like, if you really want to pursue something musically, you know, we can look at that outside of school. It's easier to find, you know, I don't know, if he picks an instrument, like, if he wants to play the guitar, drum, something, like, we could probably do that, you know. I don't
want to
pay for it, but I will.
I know, that's right.
But I'm like,
expensive,
it's so expensive. That's an easier program. As a drama program, there are a little more of a commitment to do outside of school. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So I think that's a better...
You can actually compensate with the community.
And they said that, like, when we visited the program, I didn't like how they did it. It was just for parents.
Move around.
To see music, they teach you how to read music, whatever.
You're
sitting there, it's a lot of, it's lecturing,
they're
teaching
you, you know. Mm-hmm. Like, you don't have that. Why do you need more than that?
Take advantage of this. Exactly. You know, it's just a little more, I think it will cultivate a different part of the camp.
You're growing up. You can stop complaining by 4th grade.
Wow. Now, believe me, when you get grown and you see all the other stuff you have to deal with in life, you'll be wishing that you were having, like, a 7th grade.
Right. My son would be saying that. He said, I wish I could be a kid forever. I said, damn.
Look, at least he knows.
He does know. I don't know why, because he's seen his mama. And he knows me after having a kid this young. It ain't, let me not play with myself.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And what are we doing right now at home?
What?
Homework.
Mm-hmm.
Not homework, he already completed that in school. It's more of homework that I did.
Like additional.
Yeah. And I don't like to do that because, you know, I do understand how kids need a moment to let their brain breathe or whatever.
Yeah.
But in his case, he did recently get his progress report and he's lacking a little bit in math.
Yeah.
So, you know, we got to pick that baby back up. And I understand why, because mm-hmm. I didn't really do much because it takes me at home to teach him.
Yeah, because you were doing extra.
Yeah. It takes me to do that for him to catch it. I don't know why.
Right.
But I understand also the philosophy of one person trying to teach 25 people at the same time.
Right.
You know, not everybody can catch it.
No.
So, that I have to do my responsibility, do my part to teach him as well. So, I slacked off a little bit last year because I felt like he was good. But, and then they showed me that too in his report cards and tests. But, okay, showing that his progress report. I'm like, okay, what a way to start off the year.
Right.
So, what we're going to do is, instead of doing schoolwork every day, homework, I mean, every day, we'll just do it twice a week, and then you go ahead and you just learn what you're, you know, not good at and call it a day. So I'm trying to make it less pressure on him because that means less pressure on me.
Just make it a routine.
Yeah. Twice a week, today, the Tuesdays and Wednesdays, so just the beginning of the week and the end of the week, just the way you want.
And no, they're not hiring everywhere because they cannot find enough teachers.
Maybe if they actually pay them the proper way, have a proper ecosystem flowing. I don't even know how that even works. Like, it is ridiculous. Yep, the future. So I just finished washing you, like tried to washing you three times with this clarifying shampoo. Because the first couple times it didn't really set up.
Okay.
So this last time it did.
Probably because I really have been oiling, so I'm like, I don't know something with it too much. Because like you said, I think a lot of people do.
Yeah, I could tell the actual like flip too. Yep.
Mm-hmm. Because so, I can tell from how itchy my scalp is or
is
not. You know?
And on a scale of 1 to 10. So it's scale of 1 to 10, you'd say?
As far as itchy? Mm-hmm. Maybe like a 3 these last. Yay. Like recent, you know, like because I've been the last
time
I watched. This is
probably 1 to 2 weeks. That's good. You're at a 3? Wonderful. So yeah, you don't really have a scalp issue. I'm going to just reset your scalp too. So after I finish clarifying it, I'm going to use the scalp wellness shampoo to reset your scalp. Not reset, it's just basically the balance of pH.
Okay.
And then I'm going to use the honey one just to make your locks up with the softening your locks. And detangling your roots.
Yeah, the roots are like, that was one that I had, I was in the, before, I'll say this last month, maybe even 2 months. No, I think I haven't seen
it
since I went, since I sober. But I think I
can see it. Ooh, yeah,
Seattle.
Is that good? Let's go.
Yeah, I think Seattle was the last time I tried. All right,
man.
And that was like middle of October.
I love that. That means you know something good.
I'm trying. But I have not twisted them as much as I was before. You know, like I kind of slacked on that. Which, on the one hand, it was encouraging. I was seeing how well they were locking.
Right? Shampoo that I first used was high in
which one was that?
When I say high, I mean alkaline. Okay. Because clarifying shampoo is the first one. That one, it's a shampoo that is meant to help clean.
Mm-hmm. But is it sulfates or no sulfates?
It has to have sulfates.
Okay.
So that way it clarifies and cleans it. It has to have some form of like salt in there to strip that hair clean and make it clean. Okay. This is why they say don't use sulfate shampoos every day.
All the time, yeah.
Because it will strip your hair.
Take everything.
Yeah, everything. So what I did was use that because I wanted to get your scalp and your hair, your locks as clean as possible. As you can see, it took about 3 washes before it started to foam up.
Yeah.
And now, you know, due to the buildup and the oil, because you know, the oil does tend to repel water, so it took a minute for it to penetrate. Mm-hmm. But we got through. And now we're using the scalp wellness shampoo, and that one is just helping the scalp, like I said, reset the hair and the scalp to its original pH, because the clarifying shampoo was alkaline, it was 8.5 to 9.5, and that's pretty high. Our hair and our skin and our nails lives and thrives at 4.5 to 5.5 on the pH scale, right? So when I use that product, it's going to take you out of whack, right? It's going to bring you way up on the pH scale, which isn't safe. Right. Being too high, if it's acidic, can be a problem for the hair and scalp, right? So now I'm using scalp wellness shampoo to help bring you back down the pH. And the honey detangling shampoo is the same. It's acidic. It's going to be the same thing. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it will also be something to get
better.
Yeah, that's my favorite one. Yay! I'm so glad you enjoyed
that. And the hair like savers, they change the game like that and just doing it well.
Yep. And hydrating before you apply your oil.
Yes.
So you don't put it in your skin.
That's the part that she doesn't like so much. She's just like, she just like when I need to spray, but I'll be like spraying it on my hair. Because like usually I'll do it like if we shower, bath, and we can get the hair much wetter. But like, you know, if it's just like doing it, you know, sitting down, like, you know, sitting down, like, you know, it's like, it's just like, it's a lot of water.
She's like over it.
Putting all my skin in her ears.
You're doing too much, mom.
Yeah.
You better
wrap. What I like is that she was so cute. Is that she went like, she's in her baby doll face and she's been friends with all these baby dolls. And she's been through her baby doll thing one day. She came up to me and she told me she needed the spray bottle and the oil.
I'm dead.
And I was like, girl, I was like, I love that you know.
What's this?
But I was like, also, no.
You're not enough. You wasted it on her. Her. No. What's the good stuff?
I like the water.
Give me some fake vegetable oil or something.
Okay,
you girl. You better. It's the good stuff. Mm-hmm. She knows what to do, honey. That's wonderful. She's taking account of that. So that means she's going to be ready to help herself when she gets older. Because I know a whole bunch of young teens right now who don't want nothing to do with doing their hair. And it's just crazy to me. Like, who raised you? I started doing my hair at 6. Like, I kind of low-key had no choice. You feel me? Yeah. As soon as my mom found out I could do a braid, she's like, okay, do your little sister and her too. Yeah. Like, and do mine once you get better. Like, what? What are you talking about? That's patience and practice. Practice and patience and lots of YouTube if you can catch it.
I know, that's what I started doing. Because I kind of was just like acting. I was like, yeah, to get some tips.
Yeah.
Even and just listen. Like watching like how they're holding, you know, I didn't like just do a braid, you know what I mean? But I mean like actually like braiding, like braiding her whole hand so that it looks good. And doing formulas and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Like, that to me, like I need more tips. You know what I'm saying? Like I can't just like figure that out.
That's how it be with locks. As long as you're like getting the scalp intentionally and then you're working through the hair afterwards, and then like you can treat, like I don't know if you ever washed the hair by, I mean wash laundry by hand,
mm-hmm.
but when you treat it like laundry, basically, that's actually the thing that helped me like understand hair better, knowing that hair is fabric. Hair is like fabric, it's just like fabric. You know, you have burlap soap, you know, you got cotton, you got polyester, and things. You have different types. And they all react differently to heat, water, you know what I'm saying? They expand and become tracks, you know what I'm saying? They're all derived from plants as well. So it's like, okay. When it comes to, think of like ironing, right? How when you straighten your hair and when you're blowing it out, you notice that. It always dry, your hair kind of gets bigger again. You can see the curls come back.
Right.
But when you blow it out while it's wet, it's very slick and smooth.
Right.
So it same applies to when you're like ironing a shirt.
Yeah.
It's got wrinkles and you just iron it dry. Right. Those wrinkles come back almost immediately.
Right.
Versus, right, if you spray some water on it, like my mother taught me, or use starch, and then you iron it, those wrinkles go away and they stay away. Yeah. So it's kind of the same. Kind of talk about that concept.
That is interesting. I never heard about that. Like, I never thought of it that way. Like, it's so true. Even when you think about like fabric that you can wear, it's just like your skin cells are really good on it, and it affects the fabric over time.
Oh yes. Oh yes. Oh yes. So yeah, it's a little thing trying to have people understand and try to associate hair with laundry, cooking, and gardening. Wet. So it's the same thing as the plant. It's also the same as when you're washing clothes and having to, you know, use softeners for certain things and put cold water for certain things and warm water and
you know.
Right, yeah, like a
cold rinse. Yeah, all that. All that plays. It's all about elasticity, expansion and contraction. That's what our hair does. That's why it can do many different things. So if we can apply that to hair, I mean, the fibers, like my hair are high hair fibers, and clothes have fibers. And they're all really food derived from plants, clothes derived from plants, we're derived from plants, we're plant beings, we have the same low-key anatomy. You know what I'm saying? So it's something to think about, and it helps you realize, okay, if I wouldn't do it when I'm cooking, if I wouldn't do it when I'm like cleaning, if I wouldn't do it, why did somebody hair?
It's like thinking about, yeah, like you wouldn't just like, when people talk about keeping bad for your hair, well, it's not that simple. But like, you think about like ironing your shirt, you leave
iron
on it,
what
and
happens?
You walk away, like you
don't
burn it.
Exactly, or if you put it on high, yeah, what happens? Now you got a stain, and you, which is considered hair damage or the over processing, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, it's really cool. Something to think about. Hair is a fabric. So if y'all didn't know, follow Texture versus Race. Texture versus Race on Instagram. They taught me a lot of stuff that I do know. Went to an event that I didn't even think that I needed to go to because I was able to win a free ticket to go.
Yeah.
I bought a flight, paid for a hotel, went there. Oh my God, the amount of information.
Really?
About naturally textured hair. It was mind blowing.
Where was that?
It was in Baltimore. That was like a year or two ago. I think it was 2 years ago. Texture versus Race Summit. I think they're having another in March. The thing is, I don't like Baltimore when it's cold.
Yeah.
But like, come on.
It's pretty
close. Yeah, like,
why are they?
Like, yeah, the harbor is gorgeous. That's where we were last time. The harbor is beautiful. It's like, why is it gotta be in the cold? Like, come on now. I was dying the last time I went. It was in November. I was dying.
That's so funny.
I'm a Miami girl, honey.
I know.
I can't. I don't know what that is.
I already see, it's already like starting to change us, like being down here, because I'm just like, okay, why is it 60 degrees and I feel like it's cold?
Yeah. Yes, when I say 64 and I'm shivering.
I would have never felt that way, like up north, like ever.
You haven't even been here that long, girl. You already
come. This is what I'm saying. I'm like, this is like, it's messing with my whole mind and like body, like the balance of everything.
I can't
sense
you.
Of hot and cold. What is this? Like sweaters. Oh, no. Like in New York, I'm like 60. Yes, like
this is nice weather.
Yeah.
Ew. Ew, y'all crazy. Alright, so this is the honey. And if you use them, try to put it in like a little bit on your hand and rub it through your hair and have your hair soaking wet before you do that. So you don't need much conditioner in order for it. I mean, leave a conditioner so that way you can, regular conditioner so that way you can like penetrate and also not be too heavy. Or you can, just come out of the shampoo and your hair again and you use a light leave-in spray that way. If you're going to have to use that, and it basically works.
That's it.
You spray it on your locks. Don't need to put it on your scalp. Spray it on your locks.
So I was worried about using any kind of thing like that.
Don't use a lot. Just spray it up there. You'll feel your locks get soft. You'll feel it. And you just rub it through your locks. Like I'm basically running my hair through your locks now. And you put some oil on your scalp and you roll it right into your locks. So that way you can open that leave-in conditioner to put in. And you just put it on your next one.
Yes.
Or be like that. for real. No, and if you want, you can split it in half. It is. And you can split it in half and add water. Okay, draw a little bottle. Because I feel like hers would be hers.
That's a lot of hair.
I was about to say that. It's best if she had one that's... So she has a lot of hair and stick it. It'd be best for her to have a concentrated version. But you could take the oil bottle after you have a bottle, you stick some out of your cord in there, add some water. You'd be all that'd be perfect. Let her keep concentrating and use the diamond force.
She definitely would be
a lot of you lock clients.
New lock
clients? A lot of you lock clients.
New lock clients.
There's a lot, but I have a lot of lock clients. So that's actually why I'm looking for a lock tissue now. Because
wow.
I'm like, okay.
Right.
I think it's like a little gal.
Yeah.
So it's a lot of lock clients. But it low-key kind of started out like that because my baby daddy was my first client.
Okay.
And he started out his locks. I mean, everyone started to follow suit. And I'd say locks first, so I could say locks is at 40%. I could say that braids are at 35%, and then I don't even push them to like 39%, and then I could say that natural hairstyle is 21%, for sure. Yeah, and that's like once every like, when Cody's gone, okay? It's like once every... basically 3-4 months because they're coming to get a relaxer touch-up.
Right.
I barely see them, so and it's like not even a handful, like maybe 3 or 4.
Wow.
Who get a relaxer?
I'm kind of surprised because I would think like a lot of the braids, because I just feel like braids don't make me get braids now, whether it's like, you know,
that's why I said 39%.
Or maintenance, or it's like for vacation, you know, it's just like, I'm just like, it's really so popular.
It is. That's why I said for 39%,
yeah.
And that's why I said locks is 40. It's basically the same. You know what I'm saying? It's just 1% less because lately, I could for sure say my personal lock clientele base has just increased. Like, there will be some dips that people don't want to get braids or they're alternating different styles, right? But my lock clients are my forever. And it's consistent. It's consistently growing. So it's like, okay, gotta split that love. Because they used to be braids, 60%. Locks 30% natural hairstyles. I say locks, 30% natural hairstyles, 10%. That's what that was. They switched for the past year and a half. Locks just as much as braids.
I feel like you said people commit to locks for a long time, and it's like any time.
You know what? I'm glad you mentioned it. That just made me realize how it's because I think I start off locks now. Because the instant lock method, that's what's increasing the clientele. It's the love of
people looking for that.
About like 80% of the people who start their locks with me keep coming back to it and keep them being meant to maintain. And I'm now realizing that's what that is. Got it. Okay, new service alert.
Scalp.
going to do is grab the towel and squeeze some water out first. We need a little locks back here.
I know. We're finally grown. Remember how that feels so tiny?
It's giving Bob now. By your anniversary, you're gonna be able to celebrate with ponytail. Let's do it. I feel like so.
One more time, April.
You could totally do that. Okay, here it's nice and clean. So, I'm gonna go ahead and show y'all what I do after I shampoo. Like I said, we do not have conditioner, but instead we use a light leave-in conditioner spray. So, you can put it around your neck, and you have a seat over there. Perfect. And then, your gold tips are beautiful.
Thank you. I know you were saying, like, and it just was a fluke that I happened to have that I was growing my hair out and I decided to give it a lot.
This is gorgeous. Like, I can see where it's dark brown. Like, okay, so your natural dark brown, and then it gets brighter brown, and then it gets like a gold, and then it comes blonde, and it's like, oh my god, this is gorgeous.
Well, and I'm excited too, for like, I'm gonna get taller.
Mm-hmm. That is a thing. People, you have so many things you have to think about when it comes to hair. Weather too, y'all. Weather too. So we're gonna use this leave-in, some diluted, to feel nice and soft, moisturized. And I'm not focused on the scalp. I'm focused on the locks, the hair itself. Stop. I'm gonna give her a view of the you like, you about to fall asleep, girl. Yeah. Alrighty, so for you, we're just going to do a regular retwist and palm twist.
Yeah.
And I call it a day. Your hair is nodding so beautifully. Wow.
Yeah, I felt like a very distinct difference. I could tell when I actually started to laugh.
Okay, so here I can go ahead and blow out her hair a little bit. I'm gonna put it on warm, and I'm not gonna do too much. I just want to make sure it's not dripping as I'm twisting, because you can't twist the hair while it's wet. I personally twist my hair when it's wet. Like, I've even recently tried retwisting my hair while I was in the shower. It was the best feeling ever. Like, you have to try it yourself to know what I'm talking about. So if you're wondering if you can retwist your hair while it's wet, yes, you can. Actually, it's more healthier that way because your hair is wet. You have more elasticity with the twist, and it can last longer because when you have the hair wet and you manipulate it, put it in a specific style and set it, it tends to dry in that state and it tends to last longer. So, just a little tip. But I don't want her dripping. I'm gonna dry her up.
Thank you.
She's feeling herself. I love it here. Okay, I love it. Feel your hair, feel your locks. Do you notice a difference?
Softer.
That's the key word. Softer. So like I said in the steps, when you shampoo and condition, you don't condition. And then you spray a light leave-in, okay? Nothing heavy cream based, nothing water based, and then you put an oil on your scalp and then massage it in and then spread that through the rest of your locks after you've applied the moisturizer, which is focused on the hair as well when you apply that. You'll notice that the softness in your hair lasts so much longer. The buildup, you barely get any of that. And when you're consistently cleansing your hair too, you ain't gotta worry about that buildup stuff. Locks are low maintenance, but they're not no maintenance, okay?
That was like the first thing you taught me about, but that is always the refrain in my head.
Trying to be lazy? Hear my little voice in your head. Okay, so what I'm gonna do for you is